Sean, who is the brand manager for GMC trucks here at the International Auto Show in Toronto, joining me now with one of the coolest cars I think I've ever seen. This is incredible. I remember Hummers back in the day. They didn't look like this.
Not at all. So this is the brand new, first ever Hummer, GMC Hummer EV all-electric super truck.
Wow. This is incredible. What makes it so super?
So this was a purpose-built EV vehicle designed from the ground up to provide exceptional capabilities both on and off-road with really a zero compromise experience. And of course, the best part of this vehicle is there is absolutely no tailpipe emissions.
It's so quiet in here. They're having some test drives of cars going around. You hear nothing but the rubber on the pavement. That's it. It's so cool. Some of the interior features, are they customizable?
Yes. So all the screens are color customizable screens. We worked with Unreal Engines to help design those and get them perfect for our customers.
Oh my gosh, that's so great. So you can do a lot of customization with every single vehicle, correct?
Absolutely, yes.
So you can get in, you can choose the color of the car, the color of your seats, all the bells and whistles, and you can either have it fully loaded or not so much.
Yeah, so we'll have we're introducing the Hummer model. We're introducing it with the Hummer EV Edition 1. Mm-hmm. And then beyond that, you'll be able to select a couple other trim options that will be available.
Can we get in it?
Absolutely.
Let's go. Get in it. I'm super excited. Yeah, I remember driving around in a Hummer, and I'm not going to date myself, so I'm not going to say when it was, but it was a long time ago. Okay, some of the features. Show me what you got.
So what we're going to demonstrate here is rear wheel steer featuring crab walk.
Crab walk? Is that like the party trick?
Exactly. So what that allows customers to do is turn both the front and the rear wheels at the same angle up to 10 degrees to drive on a diagonal. So picture, we've got a pylon in front of us, but picture that you're in an off-road trail, maybe that's a boulder that you don't have room to go around, so you need to find a way to maneuver around it, and that's what we're going to demonstrate here.
This is so cool. This is like so, it's so futuristic to me, and I'm not, you know, a huge car person, so I don't know a ton about cars, but this just seems so technically advanced.
Absolutely. So we put on the crab walk mode. We approach the obstacle in our direction. And as you see, when you turn the wheel, both the front and rear wheels will turn at the same time, allowing you to drive on a diagonal.
And it's so smooth.
Absolutely.
Like you really feel like you're driving your living room around right now.
No kidding.
It is so incredible. I mean, we're on a very smooth surface. Yes. Any other really cool features you want to share with us?
So a big part of this is, obviously, this does allow for rear wheel steer, which what I can show here is there's quite a small turning radius of this vehicle.
Whoa!
And I apologize for the cones here. So as you can see, it's quite a large vehicle.
Yeah, but
with a
your
very
radius,
small turning radius.
You're turning like you're on rails.
Exactly.
That's super cool.
But yeah, really the focus here was that we wanted to create a vehicle with like excellent maneuverability both on and off the road. And by allowing those rear wheels to turn with the front, you really provide an exceptional driving experience.
All right, well, thanks so much, Sean. This has been a ton of fun. Our tour of the International Auto Show continues after this. Lots more coming up on Morning Life. Yeah, it's kind of like Knight Rider on steroids. Officer Kerry Schmidt joining me with the OPP. This is a Corvette, right?
This is a beautiful car.
This is insane.
This is a Z06 2023 C8 Chevy Corvette. General Motors and Chevrolet were kind enough to loan it to us for the show. It will not be on the roads.
Oh, I was just going to say, is this your upgraded vehicle?
I know, but it's certainly turning a lot of heads here right now. You know, we've got our other car, our Chevy Tahoe. We've got a bunch of cars in the background here as well. Mm-hmm. And come on down, check it out. We're hiring. Anyone thinking about a career in law enforcement?
You know,
this is kind of what we're doing. We're trying to cause some buzz, and there's been a lot of buzz with this car.
The internet
kind of broke when people started seeing this thing out in the highway. Over the weekend.
Wait, it was driving around on the highway?
No, it was trailer. You'll see the spy photos. People saw it as we were hauling it down here. And it certainly...
And everybody thought, oh my gosh, if those are the new OPPs, we are all in trouble right now.
Oh yeah, my phone blew up. But it was a lot of fun. And we finally pulled the covers off the mystery of why we're here. Mm-hmm. And we would love everyone to come by and check this car out, take some pictures, and talk to recruiters.
Yeah.
If you have questions about the law, with the OPP, what we do across the province, you know, again, here's an opportunity to have a great conversation.
And this will not be your car. Yeah. This is not your trainer car. This is not the car you're going to start in. Maybe an upgrade in a few years from now. Any really cool special features that you think we should know about?
Well, you know, okay, Zeno 6 C8 rear engine. I don't have all the horsepower specs on it. This is a fully...
But it's fast.
It looks fast. It's just sitting here right now. Beautiful red leather interior. Big wide tires, you know, it's an amazing car.
Yeah.
And it's getting all kinds of attention here from everybody that's walking by. And so if you want to come check it out, take a few pictures. We got a bunch of swag here as well.
Yeah, this is awesome.
And we got the EV test track behind us. There's all kinds of people.
Yeah, I just got to go in the Hummer. It was
walking
a lot of fun.
By. So yeah.
Yeah,
come
super
on by.
Fun.
We'd love to meet you.
International Auto Show. Our tour continues on Morning Live. Stay with us. The Canadian International Auto Show is where you need to be this weekend because it's the first time it's back since the pandemic started. So we've been off for 2 years. We're now back. We're with Ruben, who's with Mattel and Hot Wheels. And there's some really cool cars here to showcase.
Absolutely, yeah. We brought all the best cars that we have at the Garage Legends of Hot Wheels. And as you can see here, we have the great Midas Monkey.
This is amazing. My 7-year-old son is coming through in jealousy out of me right now.
Absolutely, because you know what? I mean, Hot Wheels is not just a toy. It's an automotive legend, and we want to show the auto enthusiasts that they can also express their passion for cars by collecting Hot Wheels. That's why we brought this amazing fleet, and we want to start showing them. So next to the Midas Monkey, we have our 2022 Hot Wheel Legends Tour winner.
That is so
Canadian winner.
Cool. So, if I knew anything about car engines, I would think, oh, that's pretty sophisticated. I don't, but it looks neat.
And take a look at the interior. It's amazing.
Okay. Oh my gosh, the interior, the upholstery. It is so cool.
Yeah, so this is a Toyota Celica, and it was built by our very own from Windsor, Kevin Hutt, and he won last year the Hot Wheels Legends Tour in Canada.
No way.
Yes.
That is so cool. I love how you're getting so involved in the community and really kind of teaching people about cars and what's so special about them, and I just think it's really neat.
It's a very passionate community.
Yeah.
We want to, you know, reach out to them and show them how cool is collecting Hot Wheels and Hot Wheels overall.
Yeah, absolutely. What's this one right here? This is bopping.
So on our display, we also have some cars that have been submitted by people on the auto show, and we have chosen the cars that make you go wow. So along with the Hot Wheels fleet that we have brought, you will see some of these cars. And as you can see, these are all Ontario builds.
Wow,
so
1966.
Very excited to share the floor with them.
Okay, this is pretty cool. What is this? What kind of car is this?
Corvette. Yeah, modified Corvette.
Modified Corvette.
And we have a very special car on the corner.
Is that the Batmobile?
No, it's not the Batmobile.
Because it looks like the Batmobile.
It's another movie star, though.
It is. Well, don't tell me now. Now I feel like I should know this. Garage of Legends. Oh, it's the Darth Vader car.
Yes.
I should have known that. Okay, tell me about this car.
So this is part of our Garage of Legends. It's one of the 25 cars that we own as Hot Wheels. It came all the way from El Segundo, and it's based on the iconic character, right? Star Wars.
It is so
as
neat.
You can see on the side, it has lightsabers. It's a pretty cool build.
Wow, it does. It looks just like his helmet, but it's
does.
A car version.
Yeah. Here at the auto show during the next 2 days, the actual designer who designed this is going to be here on site. So
you
can get a chance to talk to him as well.
That's really cool.
Very exciting things happening at the auto show.
And if you bring your kids down, there's some Hot Wheels toys that you can play with as well. They can have a tour. I know my kids would just love this.
Absolutely. If we go over this side, we have the kids' zone, which we're going to be featuring some of our most iconic places.
Yes.
And RC.
Yeah, so monster trucks.
Absolutely.
That's huge.
We have a remote control area here, so kids can be, you know, like...
Yeah.
Playing around with remote control Hot Wheels.
Yeah.
And we have the playset area over there.
Yeah, my kids would never leave.
Yes,
absolutely.
This is going to be very exciting.
Yeah.
It's going to be a fan favorite.
Yeah,
and
I think so too.
If that is not enough, we have a Toys R Us store just going right outside our booth.
Okay.
Where you can get all these
where
sets
you can buy all
and
the
all
toys.
These remote controls. Yes.
All right. Well, thanks so much, Ruben, for joining us, having a lot of fun here at the Canadian International Auto Show.
Thank you.
80s and 90s car and culture show, Oblivion. Here we are with Justin. Justin, this room is super cool. I'm loving the vibe. It's got Madonna on the stereo. We've got a bunch of cool 80s cars, board games, arcade. Tell me about the space.
Well, what you just said, the 80s and 90s are here and alive in Oblivion. And we love to bring this stuff back because it's about time.
Yeah.
If you enter this room and it doesn't trigger a memory in some of the Easter eggs we've hidden out throughout there, then we failed.
Okay.
I think we haven't.
Well, we're going to start looking for those Easter eggs right now. The first one I see is the Jurassic Park Jeep. That is so cool.
Yeah. One of our showgoers did an excellent job of recreating that replica. And it makes people remember that movie very quickly. Very well done.
I remember the scene of the little girl in the back seat when the car is like getting crushed by one of the dinosaurs, and I'm thinking, oh gosh, somebody needs to save her.
And there's a surprising amount of detail that goes into these replicas.
I believe
it. We'll get to in a moment.
Okay, I think this is probably my favorite car of the entire auto show, and I have driven in the electric Hummer, and I have also seen the OPP Corvette.
Oh.
So this is saying a lot.
It does say a lot.
The DeLorean.
Yes.
Looks exactly.
Yeah, it's a fairly.
This is a replica.
It's a fairly screen accurate replica done by my friend Ken Kapalowski. So I do the mechanical part of this vehicle. I own Wells Auto, which is a DeLorean dealership. But the time machine bit is done by my friend Ken.
Wow.
So we don't generally build time machines, and we don't really. But he has gone to Universal Studios, worked on the original car that you see in the movie, and his car is modeled after that. So the detail you see in here, and every time I drive this car, I need to remember how to turn something on. I'm like, well, how did it work in the movie? Oh, I know.
No, you remember Michael J. Fox being like, how did he do this?
And if there's something that doesn't work like it did in the movie, I ask Ken why.
But are you putting bananas in the flux capacitor?
Well, you know what? I was about to say, the Mr. Fusion's not on this version, so if you put that in the plutonium chamber, it won't work.
No, I didn't think so. Oh my gosh, I totally remember those paintings. What were they called?
Magic Eye. And we have Magic Eye all throughout this entire back wall.
Then you'd have to stare at it until you see the actual image.
I did test them out and made sure they all work.
They all work?
Yes.
How long do you have to stare at it for? I probably
don't
have time.
If you cross your eyes slightly, it seems to help. I can get them pretty quick now.
Oh, I had it. I had it and then I missed it. Tell me about this red car while I'm trying to do this.
This is a 1991 Honda Civic Special Edition. It's my car, actually.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's only got 31,000 original kilometers on it, and it's an absolute survivor. Every one of these cars had been modified or rusted out or driven into the ground. This car was well-loved by its original previous owner, and we have restored it to absolute perfection.
That's amazing.
Yeah, it's available to somebody who will love it as much as I do, or I'll just keep it, whatever.
Yeah, it'll just be mine forever, and that'll be the end of it.
That's kind of how I feel about a lot of stuff I have.
Yeah. Okay, well, Luke is taking us into the arcade, so you really, and you brought back, like, original computers.
Oh, yes.
What are we playing on there?
So that's our upgrade for this year. We had the arcade machines last time around, as well as some of the consoles that we grew up with as well. But this time, we've also added a Commodore 64,
yes,
Pentium 1, and a Mac G3.
This is... So, oh my gosh, and the original Nintendo.
Yep, so we have
Atari.
Nintendo, Atari, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, as well as, again, the computers that you see over here.
So I would never leave this room.
Yeah, there's no reason to leave this room.
Yeah, I've seen what I need to see. Yeah.
And for $5 for anybody who comes to the show, they get a pass and they can come in and go as they want for the entire duration of the show.
Oh, that's amazing. All right, well, thanks so much, Justin. We've had so much fun in here.
Awesome.
I'm going to play some games, I think.
Please do.
Do I have to do anything or can I just play?
No, just go for it.
Just go for it.